cop. Who are you there with?
Who are you talking to?
You. Aaron, bend over, Robin.
It's the trooper at the bakery again. I mean, it could be worse, right? At least I'm not saying, oh, back at the crack house, or even back at the bar. So I like baked goods, okay? Send me to rehab. Actually, I might need rehab for that. So I checked Bravo. Aria has 31 names on the list. So I came to Resorts World, put my name on the list right now, and ever since I had those tacos the other night, I've had this sick feeling of regret that I didn't get pizza. So I think I'm gonna go have a slice of Mulberry Street pizza. I'm leaning towards barbecue chicken, but I'm also leaning towards buffalo chicken. And I'm only gonna get one slice because I don't wanna fall asleep in the poker room, because I feel like I owe Resorts World Poker Room a little bit of a spanking. Now, I could walk all the way to the front of the casino and get a slice of pizza, but come on, for real. When I first saw my slice of barbecue chicken pizza, I thought, uh-oh, looks like it might be a little crusty. Holy shit, was it good. It was crispy. It was like on the, a little slightly past done. For some reason, it was delicious. It was really, really good. Yo, it's a nice night out here. It's a little warmer than I would like it to be. They say the winter's gonna be a little warmer here than usual. Looks like it's 73 right now. Guess I can live with that. You know, I think it's really funny because lately I've seen some really funny tweets from an account called Defiant L's, as in losses. Dude is photobombing the back of the camera. And so I've retweeted a bunch of them because they're hilarious. It's a guy or a girl saying something, taking like a hardcore stance, sometimes pretty hateful stance about something, and then 1 month later doing the exact opposite and basically saying that other people are wrong for doing the same thing that person did, or for just taking an opposite stance because it's a different person. Most of these people are tweeting about things that are political, but no matter which side you're on though, hypocrisy is hypocrisy. So I think that a lot of it is ridiculous. I think hypocrisy in general is ridiculous. If you're gonna believe in a certain thing, what's this guy doing? Probably looking for an ass beating, walking around the middle of the street. You didn't see him, he's back there. But like, a lot of it is like, I gotta tell you, I'm not a huge fan of Donald Trump as a person. And I am definitely not a fan in any way of Joe Biden at all. I think the chances of having a president of the United States and or a majority of Congress people who are good for America and good for freedom, I think the chances of having that are pretty damn slim no matter what side you're on. What is this guy doing? It's not a traffic light, it's a stop sign. You only have to stop for a certain amount of time until your right of way is clear. The guy was sitting there like he was waiting on the stop sign to turn, like he was waiting on the stop sign to turn, I don't know what's happening here. Like he was waiting for the stop sign to turn green. So it would appear that a lot of people on Twitter are butthurt. And here's the reason they're butthurt. No matter what I believe, no matter what side of the aisle I might lean towards, which, by the way, I'm gonna say it right now, I lean towards freedom. That's it, freedom, freedom of speech. All of the Bill of Rights, I absolutely stand for the freedom of people with whom I vehemently disagree to say whatever they want to say. This isn't about my beliefs. This is about how ridiculous it is that no matter what I believe, if I point out the hypocrisy of a person, if the demonstration of hypocrisy leans a certain way and it leans away from one side, then everyone on that side immediately wants to blast me for being on the other side. When the tweet didn't really have anything to do with what side you're on, it has to do with illuminating hypocrisy. Because I think it's ridiculous that someone with a blue check mark would tweet, "Fuck Donald Trump," and then 2 months later tweet, "The people who are saying fuck Joe Biden are garbage." Like, look, if I were to say fuck Joe Biden, if I were to say let's go Brandon, I absolutely would never try to say that you can't say fuck Donald Trump. It's just funny because I open Twitter and I see people who are fans of me saying that I shouldn't point out hypocrisy for some weird reason. Like, no, I'm gonna point out whatever I wanna point out, number one, but I also see people that I muted 6 years ago who are just like venomous, right? So I muted them and they're still following me on Twitter years later and complaining about the things that I might retweet. If a guy goes on Twitter and says, "I hate the color red," and 2 weeks later goes on Twitter and says, "I love the color red," I think it's funny, I think it's deranged, and I like to point it out because I find it humorous.
Let me buy you a coffee, just because you're working hard and I know how it is, so that's all. Just a coffee or something on your break. Yeah, no problem, thanks.
There was a lady handling the trash in the parking garage, and she was just so nice. She was like, you know, how are you? And she was like, have a good evening. She was just like the sweetest lady, and she's working hard doing the trash, so I'm like, I don't know, I just felt like buying her a coffee or whatever she might use $5 for. Note to self, select small size. I know there's something going on. Remember that song? I love that song. Yo, session started out a little bit rough. Today, just a little bit rough, not super rough, a little bit rough, a little bump in the road. And then I got crazy lucky in a hand, and then I played some more hands, and that's the end of the poker portion of the vlog. I win $221 for the night. I'm in for 602, out for 823. And yeah, I want to say shout out to the guy in seat 9, when I first sat down, you got up, I moved to your seat, you come back and said hello. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Also, shout out to Poker Prophet on YouTube, who this is the third time I'm at the table with him. And I really did fold ace queen. Of course, why would I not fold ace queen in that spot? And yeah, what else is there to tell you? It is a Monday night in November. That's right, it's November 1st. Starting off November 1st with a win. I actually intended to get up early today and come to Resorts World and play the tournament at noon. I actually think it starts at 12:10 p.m. It's a $160 tournament. But I just didn't make it. I got so wrapped up in watching YouTube last night. I was watching all kinds of Red Hot Chili Peppers documentaries. I was watching carpool karaoke. Next thing you know, it's 6 a.m. and I was gonna get up at 9 to come here and play a tournament. Are you nuts? Oh yeah, by the way, Old Man Coffee.
Hey, it's Old Man Coffee.
Keeps me informed on certain things. He sent me a text earlier. If you are coming to Trooper Thursday this week, don't fret. They're charging $50 for parking, but with 1 hour of play in the poker room, your parking will be validated. I don't know what the hell's going on that they would charge $50 for parking, but that is the situation this week. According to Old Man Coffee Chris, remember if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. That's right, I'm talking to a camera. I'm gonna see you next time.